You're watching Adjuster TV.
In this episode, I want to talk to you about how much you can make as an insurance adjuster. As insurance adjusters, we need to be covered by insurance. We're writing estimates, climbing ladders, walking on roofs, and mistakes can happen. What are you going to do when something goes wrong? Kaplikit. CPLIC, or Kaplik for short, is an insurance company for independent adjusters, formed by independent adjusters. They understand our job and the potential problems that can arise. If you want help understanding what coverages you need as an independent adjuster, head over to cplic.net/adjustertv for a free download that will explain the common types of insurance for adjusters. Hey IAs, it's Chris Stanley of IAPath. You know how most new adjusters cannot break into the industry? They struggle because companies have 2 to 5 years worth of experience as a requirement. And how can they get that experience? But don't worry, at IAPath, we get that experience waived with our 90-day online mentorship program. If you're interested, head over to IAPath.com. Now, when considering whether becoming an insurance adjuster is a good career for you to pursue, most people want to know, what's the income potential? Now, the insurance adjuster's salary expectations can help you decide if this is a mountain you want to climb or something you want to avoid in your career. So it's pretty important. Learning about the potential of various career paths can also help you make the right choice as you get started. For example, an independent insurance adjuster salary can be higher working catastrophic claims than handling local auto damage appraisals. In this video, I'm going to review the average salaries for insurance adjusters, the career options, and the income potential, and some tips on how to get started. Are you looking for an IA firm where you're not just another number? Let me tell you about our sponsor, CCMS and Associates. CCMS has been called a big mom and pop firm because they care about their adjusters. They also care about results. The CCMS family is dedicated to training and developing a talented adjusting team. If you would like to be a part of their family, email your resume and cover letter and introduce yourself directly to careers@ccmsclaims.com. So let's start with the average salary of insurance adjusters. Now, salaries vary greatly in this industry based on location, job description, experience, and what type of employment you have. We can start, though, to draw some conclusions by looking at the available job postings in different parts of the country. On Glassdoor, out of 9,000 plus adjuster jobs, the base salary is $46,954. This tells us what the average salary to expect is, and also that there's lots of opportunity in this industry. And as a side note, I did that search during April 2020, during the coronavirus outbreak, and still there were tons of job postings. Now, this search shows that people who are senior claims adjusters, which are more experienced, earned an average of $52,000 a year, while a trainee only averages $45,000 a year. Insurance adjuster salary jumps to $52,000 in Los Angeles, while closer to $45,000 in North and South Carolina. The difference is just due to the increased cost of living in different states. When I browse Indeed insurance adjuster jobs, I find that the average is much higher than on Glassdoor. Their claims adjuster average is $53,000 per year. I also notice that there are higher earning levels of insurance claims adjusters where you see salaries close to $65,000. These higher salaries are typically reserved for experienced and traveling insurance adjusters. So how much do insurance adjusters really make? With all these numbers flying around, what can you actually expect to make as an insurance adjuster? Now, once you're established in the industry and have been working a job for more than a year, you can expect to earn in the range of $50,000. This will be higher or lower depending on where you live in the country. These salary expectations do not include the valuable benefits that most staff insurance adjusters are offered when working at an insurance company. With United States national average salary at $31,000, being an insurance adjuster earns you 62% more. That's pretty good. And it's also important to consider the various career paths, some of which you can earn much higher than average salaries. So let's talk about some of these insurance adjuster career paths. With those numbers out of the way, you can now start to consider if you even want to be an insurance adjuster. But there are many different options inside of adjusting that you can decide to pursue. You can handle residential claims as a property adjuster, inspect wrecked vehicles, or sit behind a desk handling insurance claims with the power of your mouse and speed dial. Now, let's cover a few of the more common positions in the insurance adjusting industry and what the job entails. If you enjoyed this video, you'll love riding along with us on AdjusterTV Plus. Myself and a growing list of industry experts will show you how to handle claims with confidence. We know it's hard to find a working adjuster who's going to let you shadow them, which is why we let you ride along with us on AdjusterTV Plus. Check it out for 7 days, absolutely free, at iPath.com/TV. Number one, field adjuster. These are the adjusters climbing on roofs, looking at bent metal, and working with repairers on all types to help the insured receive compensation for their loss. Now, there's exotic options like crop, marine, or heavy equipment that may be in your future if you want to be a field adjuster. Field adjusters spend a lot of time driving, so keep this in mind when deciding if it's right for you. Desk adjuster. These are the ones with a powerful pen who handle insurance claims from their desk. They do not do inspections of damaged property, but rely on field adjusters and appraisers to be their eyes and ears. Now, this is great if you don't want to climb on roofs or if you don't want to spend time as a road warrior. Both field adjusters and desk adjusters average around $50,000 a year. Catastrophic adjusters. Now, CAT adjusters travel to major disasters to handle large numbers of claims in an area. Long days and nights in hotels and in disaster zones accompany a catastrophic adjuster career path. Due to the travel and the time commitment required, their pay is typically higher than a typical adjuster. The income of a catastrophic adjuster can exceed $100,000, depending on how many days of the year you're deployed to a disaster area. Independent catastrophic adjusters, those adjusters who are for rent or hire, have even higher earning potential because they don't have a guaranteed salary. Auto damage appraisers inspect damaged vehicles in the field, but don't always settle the claim with the insured. They assess the value of the damages and the value of the damaged vehicle to assist the claims adjuster with the completion of the claim. The salary of an auto damage appraiser is similar to a claims adjuster, and the average is around $50,000 per year. So how much can you earn as an insurance adjuster? Well, it depends. What do you want to do in your insurance adjuster career? That you have to decide. My name is Chris Stanley, and we at iPath are dedicated to giving you actionable advice on how to have an amazing adjusting career that will help you break into the insurance industry so you can obtain freedom in your career and life. If you need help learning how to get work, head over to iPath.com and click the How to Find Work button. We'll send you a free video course that shares insider tips on how to get started. And until next week, keep walking your path and claiming your life.